Based on our research work with best practice teams, we've developed a five-step voice of the customer, or VOC, process for aligning customer requirements with product requirements in order to determine what customers value most. The customer's requirements are their wants, and the product requirements are how you will fulfill those wants with your product or service. This process permits the development team to focus the creation of a new product on what customers actually want and deliver it when they want it. The prioritization of customer and product requirements focuses finite resources where they can add the greatest value. This focus accelerates development cycle time. If all else fails, ask the customer. Seems obvious, but in our experience, actually asking the customer what they want is rare, especially in the technology business. Rather, we hear technologists say, they don't know what they want until we show it to them. This is leading edge stuff, and so on. There's a reason 9 out of 10 products fail. Could this be one of them? What they say they want is the listening part. What they mean and intend is your translation of what they said. What this means to us is your conversion of their wants into a product definition. What we will produce is the physical or digital manifestation of these requirements. And finally, what they say when they see the solution is your demonstration of the product to confirm it is what they wanted. The process is iterative and can occur many times during the development cycle. Best practice teams continually confirm the product's value using this process throughout the development lifecycle. What they say they want. Getting VOC is done through face-to-face meetings with many customers around the world. You have to sit with them. Online meetings don't work well for this task. What they don't say is as important as what is said. Assessment instruments such as questionnaires and visuals are critical to uncover customer needs. We keep asking why in order to get at the root needs. This is easier to do when you focus on the problem that the customer is trying to solve and how a new product might provide a solution to that problem. But focus on the problem. What they mean and intend is your interpretation of what the customer said. This is a critical step and may require multiple visits to the customer to reconfirm what you heard is what they actually said and meant. Sometimes this reconfirmation helps customers better articulate what they want. We often say, in other words, what I understood you say was blank, and is this correct, and so on. What this means to us is your translation of their wants into a product definition. The product definition is the specific way you're going to meet the customer wants. We also call these the hows. This is how we are going to implement in the product those specific requirements the customer expressed. This is often called the PRD, or product requirements document. But it explains on paper or in prototype form what the product will look like and what it will do. What we will produce is where you put it all together. What they said they wanted, how you interpreted their needs, and now what it all looks like together. Depending on the product, these vary from digital simulations and engineering prototypes to pre-production units that customers can touch or use. What they say when they see the solution is where you show it to them. Best practice development encourages early prototypes and uses these to refine customer needs and wants. This process accelerates the cycles of learning and causes faster alignment between your product concept and the customer's needs. It is typical to see multiple iterations of this throughout the dev cycle, but it must be managed or it can be a recipe for endless feature creep and schedule delay. The most common failure we see is when teams start with what they will produce. If VOC is done at all in these cases, they take their idea to the customer and ask, what do you think of the product we're going to release in Q3 next year? Most of the time, customers nod with approval or just shrug, and then the marketing team runs back to the developers to confirm that they were right on track. Later, when the product is released, it fails in the market. Why? Many cases we have studied indicate that the failed product did not meet the customer needs. The process of listening to the problems the customer is trying to solve, understanding what was really meant, and how it could be manifested in the product was bypassed because the developers were guessing that they knew what was needed or that once the customer saw it, they would buy it. The days of make it and they will come are long gone in the technology world. So if all else fails, ask the customer.